the ongoing pandemic, education has been pushed to go online. The central government and most of the state governments are encouraging online education, but without ensuring the accessibility of the internet for the students. Pushing online education in a digitally divided society reinforces the existing social exclusion of the marginalized sections, including those living in rural India, particularly Dalits and Adivasis. Aisha Natarajan, an educationist from Tamil Nadu, talks to NewsClick about the digital divide and its effect.
When we talk about the national level, this digital the divide is very alarming. India is not prepared for this online education and all. So it's quite obvious when we look at the numbers. See, when you talk about the smartphone usage, where 71% of the smartphone usage is better, only in 4 states. In all other states, you are getting 41% only. So, even at the ordinary gasket level, we can say that plenty of children are out of these online education. Then India actually, started its pandemic and that lockdown. Take, for example, on 24th of March. From 24th of March up to this date, the private schools and also the universities, the colleges, they are making hue and cry about what they are doing, about the online education, etc. But this is a big divide. According to the 2011 consensus, the census that we have taken, the consensus arrived at the statistical experts I am talking about. It is about 2.5 crore, students all over India. All over India, it is believed that there are more than about 15 to 20 crore students. But unfortunately, 2.5 crore students, they are the people who are actually at the middle class level, which they are able to afford anything like, when you call, for example, the gadgets at home, computers, connections, like that. But when you take, when you elaborate it slightly, you can see that even the middle class is today divided into three. There is one something called the lower middle class, upper middle class. There is something called the average middle class. When you talk about that and think about the children, what actually and how they what they are doing, there are five types of children in India too. The first type of children is the one, the meager amount of number of children who are at home waiting for the online class. When you talk about the majority of children, there are four types. One is the immigrant child, which is walking. You would have seen it in all the media. Now the media attention is not on them, but I came to know that 20% areas even the walking continue. Number two, the second type of child is the one who is at home because the schools are closed. When you are closing the school, you are closing the midday meals also. That's a pathetic thing in India. It has not happened in other countries. So they are at home, they don't have better food. And the parents are in a very pathetic condition. They are fighting and always there is a big problem at home. It's the second type of child. The third type of child is going along with the parent either for fishing, if it is in the, coastal area. India is having a long coastal area. And they are also working in the vegetable shops and ordinary petty shops, hotels, to help the economic condition of the folks. This is the final type of child, either is having COVID-19 or it is in the is living in the in the area where there is COVID-19 problem. So these five types of children, first type of child which is at home, which is actually in the upper middle class area, they are alone now, they are affordable. Even in that affordable set, what we are seeing is 76% of the students. That National Statistical Organization has come out with a data which was asked by RTA recently. 76% of the children of rural India, aged from 5 to 20, they are not knowing the usage of computers. This is a real pathetic picture. When you talk about the National Statistics Office data, 80% students who are inside the online education today, they are having inconvenience. For example, at the primary level, 6.8% of home in India, they have at least one gadget, a smartphone like that. And in the upper middle students, that is from, you know, talking and from 6, 7, 8 standards, 7.2% only. When you go to the higher secondary level, 11th and 12th, 15% only. So with this percentage of people, you know, having gadgets at home, how can you claim, as the government has claimed and as the private sector has claimed, that online education has come to stay, it is like this, it is like that. Big pictures of the Madras High Court interfered into the problem, and there was you know, more than about 42 days of argument in the court opening. And the Madras High Court asked the government of Tamil Nadu to set one committee that can look into this matter. Now you can see that because this, there is a delay in deciding what to do with, number one. Number two, the government committee has submitted a paper. They have not submitted papers on how they are going to take the education to the non-education area, that is the people who are really suffering, the rural, those people who are living in the hilltops. You would have seen pictures, children going to the tree class, stops and all to know about this and that. A lot of inconvenience only in that area. They are not like real classes, and it cannot happen. The government committee has not come out with what they are going to do with other children. They have come out rather about the private sector schools regarding some rules and regulations, 61 points, of what to do. Some schools, I know, they are conducting these online classes just like schools. They start by 9 o'clock, interval, lunch, till evening. It is actually, you know, of no use. Children can be put aside with the gadgets or cell phones. That is what they can do really. But the Madras High Court was very clear in one thing. The High Court cleared up the fees paying thing regarding the private schools, allowing the private schools collecting 40% of the fees during the pandemic for their online classes. So this has made a very important and disastrous thing in Tamil Nadu. There has been a lot of suicides by children regarding a pressure, regarding a lot of stress, and especially in the lower middle class children. And what has happened now, you can see very clearly. In rural areas, about 16 lakh children have migrated to the government schools. This has happened in Tamil Nadu. This is happening in every state because the parents are not able to buy cell phones, even cell phones, because they are not able to connect with the online education. So what they are doing? They are entering into the government sector where there is no online class. The government has claimed, the government of Tamil Nadu especially, that they are going to have classes on television, and such classes are, you know, broadcast on television. These classes, whether the children are attending or they are seeing, no attendance, no evidence, and the children cannot actually, you know, respond to what the lesson is taught. The lesson cannot be taught like that.
படிக்க மட்டும் தான் சொல்லுவாங்க, அவங்க அவங்களா பேச மாட்டாங்க. இதை படிக்கணும் அதை படிக்கணும்னு மட்டும் தான் சொல்லுவாங்க, ஆனால் ஒன்றுமே புரிய மாட்டேங்குது. கேட்டானா கூட அவங்க நீங்கள் வந்து அதை கவனிக்கலாம், நீங்கள் ஏன் கவனிக்கல அப்படின்னு கேட்குறாங்க. நான் கேட்டதுக்கு வந்து பதிலாக சொல்கிறாங்க, ஆனால் எனக்கு புரிய மாட்டேங்குது. எனக்கு ஸ்கூல் போகலாம் எப்படி பிடிக்கும், எப்படி ஸ்கூலில் போனால் புரியும் எனக்கு, அவங்க சொல்கிறதெல்லாம் சொல்லுவாங்க, நான் கேட்டதுனா சொல்லுவாங்க. ஆன்லைன் கிளாஸில் வந்து புக்கில் மட்டும் தான் குறித்து அனுப்பி விடுறாங்க. கிளாஸ்லேயும் அதுமாரி தான், ஏன்னா எனக்கு ஆன்லைன் கிளாஸ் வந்து புரியல அவ்வளோதான். அம்மாவுக்கு மட்டும் தான் ஃபோன் இருக்குது, அப்பாவுக்கு இல்லை ஃபோன், இன்னும் டச் ஃபோன் வாங்கலை. அம்மா வந்து வேலைக்கு போயிட்டானா தரமாட்டாங்க, இல்லைனா நைட் டைமில், இல்லைன்னா காலையில் கூட ஒரு டைமில் ஃபோன் இருக்கும், அவ்வளோதான்.
என் பேர் தமிழ் நீலா, நான் 7th ஸ்டாண்டர்ட் படிக்கிறேன். ஆன்லைன் கிளாஸ் வந்து எனக்கு புரியல, ஆன்லைன் கிளாஸ் எடுக்கிறது. நேரில் எடுக்கிறதோட இப்போ நேரில் வந்து எனக்கு என்ன டவுட்னா, நான் நேரில் டவுட்னா நான் மிஸ்கிட்ட கேட்டுப்பேன், ஆன்லைன் கிளாஸில் வந்து கேட்க முடியல. இப்போ டவுட்னா வந்து வாய்ஸ் ரெக்கார்டில் குரூப்பில் அந்தமாரி கேட்பேன். ஆனால் வந்து ஃபோன் ஃபஸ்ட்டு எனக்கு ஃபோன் வந்து நைட் தான் கிடைக்குமே எப்போவுமே. அப்போ ஏன்னா ஆஃபீஸ் போயிட்டு வரத்துக்கு நைட்டு 10 o'clock 12 o'clock ஆகிடும். அவர் 10:00 வந்தால் தான் நான் கொஷின்லாம் பார்த்து 12:00 தான் அனுப்புவேன் என் ஹோம் ஒர்க்கு. ஆன்லைன் கிளாஸில் முடியும் நான் கேட்பேனா, ஆனால் வந்து ஃபோன் இருந்தால் தானே நான் வந்து எனக்கு புரியவே இல்லை நான் ஆன்லைன் கிளாஸ் எடுக்கிறதே. இப்போ ஃபோன் இருந்தால் தான் அவங்கக்கிட்ட ஃபோன் பண்ணி கேட்கலாம், அந்தமாரி கேட்கலாம். ஆனால் அவங்க எங்கிட்ட ஃபோன் இல்லை அதனால்தான்.
So these are all many of the things that we are facing on par with this online education. And online education is conducted by the school. They are not 100% education because India was not prepared for that, number one. Number two, the teachers are not trained regarding how to handle these classes online. They are now using the Zoom meetings and other things, you know, where only the company level meetings can be held with those kind of things. It's not a classroom that you can maintain with the meeting portals. And number three, the parents were not prepared and the children were not prepared. They don't know anything about it. Just like attending a class, writing a classwork, going through the question answers. Some schools are even conducting exams online. They are calling it online exams, but they are not really online exams. Question papers are shown in the screen. Children are starting writing as usual. While you are writing something on a paper, it is not online exam at all. So these are all misunderstandings regarding online exam on online education in our country. When the people, more than about 42% only attending these classes, and 60% and above children are not inside. For example, let me talk about the secondary education. It is very, very important. Only 25.2% of the children are attending the secondary education online. What about the remaining 75%? These children are outside education. The real problem that we are facing now is when the schools are going to be reopened again, how many of these children will return to the school? See, now, we are talking big words regarding dropouts, and the SPAL committee called upon dropouts as a very big problem in India. We wanted education for all, Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. Now, the government new education policy says that online education is going to become in the future. And it also says it's a dropout, a word that it has dropped. Now it is using a word, voluntary withdrawal from school. It's a very dangerous word. And when you are going to reopen the school, then only you would know what is the real condition, what is the real situation regarding the 74% of the children who are outside this online portal. Take, for example, some areas in Assam, some areas in Northeast, and the remote areas in Bihar. Nothing can be done because these areas, there is no towers, there is no connection with the people. And in these areas, they are not considered as education areas at all. That is the real problem we are facing. And in India, like a country like India, where you have about 2,56,000 children inside the children care institutions. They are all homeless children. They are all living on the streets. And another about 3 lakh, 4 lakh children living on the streets. This kind of online education is a very big comedy. And I don't think it can be done. The real government, who calls itself a people government, should come forward with solutions. Now it is time for us to think about the solutions. What actually we can do? See, you know very well, this online education is creating poor rich gap. This online education is creating rural urban gap. This online education is creating market and free education gap. The marketed education is the one thing the government, in the center now is 100% giving its, whole concern. It's not concerning about the rural, it's not concerning about the poor children, it's not concerning about the universal education, which has to reach everybody. Now, what are other countries done? Take for example the real case of Florida, where there is a lot of black communities living, migrant children living. What they did? See, March 10th was the date Trump announced about the lockdown. March 7th, people visited the school, about the 3 NGOs, on par with the government of the Florida government, and they went class by class. Hand-raised children regarding internet connection, regarding gadgets, and after knowing that On 12th of March, they connected every house where there is no connection. They told me not pay now, please wait. And then they went for a campaign, getting the old gadgets or something, extra gadgets which people have. They gathered it. They gathered it in one place. It has happened in America. The very America which the government says it is happening there, there, look, look, look. It has happened there. What they did? They put all the gadgets together. They went to the house. Their children were called to school on 13th of March. They were standing in line on par with the COVID-19 rules. They were, whoever people don't have a gadget, they received one. It's actually a kind of a charity to the people, rich people have done. So many things can be done in this country also. The government, you know, having full amount, they recently, Amartya Sen has said that the government is well equipped now. It can, you know, educate the entire country free of. So they can get this, you know, tabs or some education equipment, which is going to be mandatory to be given to every child in this country and connect every village, and then go ahead with your online education. The Yambaib can come, the, you know, Vedanta can come. You can do anything with your own rich people. And of course, we are ready. When you are going to really support the poor to get equal and very good education as the upper middle class is now getting, it is going to be equal. See, something, you know, let me tell you, in 1896, we had the same epidemic in India. That was plague epidemic. In 1920s, even it was extended, so many years, 6 years, 7 years, it went on. You know what the British government did? They supplied a slate and a slate pencil. Slate pencils and slates were in use even in the year 2000. Then only they disappeared from our education system. When the tab came, it disappeared. So slate was the one thing the British government introduced. Only you can take slate to the school, nothing else. The slate, you can write your homework. Slate is a very important equipment regarding education. And they used it properly well. When you go to school, show it to your teacher, wash in the tap, then all the virus gone. Then you go inside, you can take down whatever you want in the slate. Same way, maybe in this 21st century, government has to supply tabs. Maybe this is what it has come to force now. But without doing anything, when you are having such a huge divide, that there are, for example, let me tell you, in Tamil Nadu, 31% of the total population, 71 million people, it is believed that they are having internet connection. That's what they say. But, you know, in Tamil Nadu, very clear, there are about 1 crore people who are having access, like laptop, or most of the laptops in Tamil Nadu, with that number also, is with the 12th standard students, who have got a free of cost from the government. The government of Tamil Nadu for the past 4 or 5 years has brought up with this is actually the government's plan to give one laptop to the children. So this is not an impossible mission. It's a possible mission. Now more than 50% of the people in Tamil Nadu don't have a cell phone. They don't have a cell phone. And in urban area, 61% have connection. Remaining 40% don't have, or 39% don't have. The rural area, it is about 41% which is having the access. Those who cannot do it, they are now migrating towards the government schools, which are locked totally, and there is no education taking place. And let me tell you, 39% of the India is now attending the online education. The remaining number of the percentage, which is about 60%, is going to have a zero academic year. The government is not going to reopen schools on part of the COVID-19 situation in its country. According to the 2011 census, about 2.5 crore children are there in Tamil Nadu, less than 18 years. 1.6 crore has one way or the other some connection with this market. In some rural areas, even one street is having one. So these people are using. In the fisherman belt, when you take, 20 of children are going along with their parents to the sea for fishing. But when they are coming back, இந்த ஃபிஷர்மேன் பெல்ட் யூனோ ஃபோர் ஆர் ஃபைவ் ஃபேமிலிஸ் ஆர் நவ் ஷேரிங் ஒன் ஸ்டாப் லைக் திஸ் த பீப்புள் தெம்செல்ஸ் ஃபைண்ட் சம் சொல்யூஷன் இன் சம் ஏரியாஸ் டீச்சர்ஸ் தெம்செல்ஸ் தே ஆர் ஸ்பெண்டிங் சம் மணி டு டூ டு வச்சு பட் த கவர்மெண்ட் ஷுட் கம் ஃபார்வர்ட் வித் பக்கா பட்ஜெட்டிங் நார்ம்ஸ் டு டூ சம்திங் ஃபார் எவ்ரி சைல்டு that this can be done or otherwise it is better to stop the other side getting it because it is going to bring a lot of problems in the future, especially a long gap between an education which is not up to the standards, because the education that now online you are giving is not the standard education. Everybody knows, take for you can take a lot of examples from what they are doing in Canada, Sweden and US. Compare it with the Indian situation, the lessons they are teaching and all those things. They are taking videos, they are putting the microphone and also the cell phone. They are, you know, just like that, talking to the child, they are doing blah, 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 blah. Then they are putting it in the groups. Now, WhatsApp groups, WhatsApp group with, you know, video, 61% of the schools are doing. Remaining number of schools only, they are going for direct on. This 61% of the schools, 7 minutes, either 4 minutes, 10 minutes videos. In 10 minutes, what a teacher can really teach you? And you are not there, and nobody, no interception. And education has 5 very important steps. One, first step is the lesson plan. Second step is actually you have to tell the topic that the outcome should be understood. And then a teaching should take place. There should be a formal discussion, because the teaching has to become learning. And finally, that should be something that the child has to do, the outcome of learning. All these things are missing, and you are coming out only with a 10 minutes of a video, and you are calling it online education. And for this purpose, a lot of amounts are in, you know, invested, and satellites are used, and plenty of things are done, you are telling, and there is channels. The central government is now ready to bring out which the child is going to see, as if they are seeing a cartoon network. How can a lesson can be taught like that? So, your standard, you have to maintain a standard, train your teachers. You have to maintain a very good standard, bring out with your own policy on this, your own policy on online education is very important. And for online education, teaching methodology is very important. All these experts should do. The government can come out with one very good expert committee to find out what they can do with the rural and the urban, what they can do to bring down the, you know, the number of people who are not inside the online education sector, what they can really do to help the teachers, what they can really do to help the children to involve themselves in study and make it a full circle study. Otherwise, it is better that I think the government can interfere and tell the private schools to wait for some more time. Because now, you know, the government has come out with the SOP, how to reopen the schools, to go ahead with, you know, from the October 15th, something like that. The central government has come out with. So on and so forth, things are when they are happening. This online education, the private schools are not going to stop. Because we know very well they have found out a very nice, you know, opening you know, for their fees and billing purpose. Now, only the government should come forward to help those people who are in a very pathetic condition, that they cannot send their children to school, they cannot have the access to the internet, they cannot have gadgets, because they are very poor. So for these things, we need solution. Otherwise, this digital divide is going to be a very huge issue, which is going to affect our future for a long time.
Mm-hmm.